Hey guys, it's Josh, and welcome back to the second episode of Nelson Tethers Puzzle Agent. Last time, we came to the small town of Scoggins, it's Minnesota, in order to investigate why the local razor factory has stopped making erasers. We met up with the local sheriff of here at the factory, who has invited us to meet him at the local diner and to look over some security footage or some case files anyway. So, I guess we should go do that.
Excuse me, I see you're working on your sign. Is it safe for me to go into the diner? Excuse me.
Gotta fix the sign.
Okay.
Something wrong with your sign? I said, is there something wrong with...
You a cop? I ain't got time for cops.
I'm not a cop.
Look, I gotta get this sign fixed before it gets dark. I don't want to be out here after dark, if you know what I mean.
I don't, actually. What do you mean by that?
It's just a fuse, but I can't remember which one it is. Not with all the whispers in my head.
What? Whispers?
Get the fuse for me. I'm getting cold out here.
Okay, sure. Now, as you can see, they've all got strange symbols on them. What may take you a second to notice is that each one is a number, but doubled and mirrored. So, basically mirrored. So, this symbol here is just a mirrored at 1, just a 2 and a 4. Here we have a 5, a 3 in the shape of a 4-leaf clover, or an X basically, and a 7, and, well, what I assume to be a 0, but I'm not 100% sure. So to complete the sequence, we're going to pick this one, the mirrored 3.
Should do it.
Hey, what do you know? This ought to keep the little buggers away.
Little what?
No, I gotta finish getting this sign down. See you later. We'll see.
I don't suppose you know anything about the eraser factory accident?
I suppose I do.
Well, that was unhelpful.
Did you know Isaac Davner?
Not much. Heard he had some kind of accident. Feel bad for his wife, Glory. Such a pretty girl.
I should really talk to her. You know where I can find her?
Yes, I do.
So, where can I find her?
In inside.
Goodbye.
Okay.
There's some tobacco on the counter. It smells like cherry. I guess the waitress hasn't been in much of a cleaning mood lately.
Ouch.
Excuse me, ma'am. Miss? Waitress lady?
Welcome to the Moose Ear Diner. I'll be right with you.
Can I help you with that?
All right, we can do this. Okay, so what we have to do is, as the thing suggested, we have to rearrange all of the food items on the plate so that none of them overlap. In case you're wondering, this would be overlapping. No, I meant to pick the asparagus, not the chicken leg. And again, not the item I was going for. That, this, of course, does not count as overlapping because they're not actually touching, so... bacon there. Okay, so the carrot must go here. I'll put the mushroom there. That there, and that there.
He's a great man. I'm so proud of him.
looks like she's got another puzzle to take care of.
Has the factory closure affected business?
Yeah. People tend to hang around here longer now that they're not going to work. Normally, that'd be a good thing. But I've been pretty distracted.
I see that. Maybe I can help.
Okay, sure. Yeah. This will be interesting. Alright, so nobody ordered a meal resembling their spouse. One lady ordered a meal resembling the fish-eating man sitting next to her. Only one patron resembles his or her meal. And the ham plate should be set down next to the banana split. Alright. Oh. Okay. Okay, so assuming that... Okay, so, assuming that they're all sitting next to their own spouses, so the man who looks like a banana, and whose head looks like a banana split is married to the chicken, and to the lady with the red hair in the back there. And the big bearded guy is married to the woman with the greenish hair that looks like, that looks sort of like fish scales. An onion head guy at the back there is on the, well, between the other two women is married to the woman that looks like a, I'm not even gonna go there. Just the woman with the oddly shaped head nose. Okay, so no one ordered a meal resembling their spouse. Only one woman ordered a meal resembling the man, a man sitting next to her. We can immediately give this woman here at the back the onion rings. Now, okay, so next, this is kind of a tough one. Okay, now. With regards to rules 3 and 4, the buffalo burger can't be given to this man here, since that doesn't leave enough space for the ham and the two adjacent items. Also, the ham can't be placed over here because the banana split doesn't fit. Because, there we go, the fish has been given to this guy.
One lady orders a meal resembling the fidgety man sitting next to her. Yep, he's eating fish. She ordered the onion rings, resembling him. Okay, so next, with regards to rule 3, the fish is already taken, so we can't give that to her. The buffalo burger also can't be given to this guy, because as the banana split doesn't fit there, and doesn't fit it over there, and doesn't leave a space for the two adjacent items. So, the banana split goes to him, resembling, well, him, and this man gets the ham. Now, following rule 1, it doesn't matter what he has anyway. But because there's no her customer ordered a meal resembling their spouse, she can't have the buffalo burger. So logic dictates she's given the chicken, and this customer over here gets the last item, the burger.
Wasn't so tough.
Yeah, I guess not.
Could I have a bit more of your time, ma'am?
Sure.
Poor Glory. Now.
Hi there. I'm Agent Tethers with the FBI. Sir, you seem stressed. Do you know something about the factory you'd like to let me in on?
I don't know anything.
Sir, it's against the law to withhold information or lie to a federal agent.
Yeah, I knew there's some stuff.
There's nothing you can tell me about the factory.
I don't co-mingle with the factory folk.
You haven't heard about anything suspicious going on, have you?
Nothing more than usual.
Okay, sure.
So, what's your name?
Steve.
Sir, I'm here about the factory. If you've got nothing to do with it, then however you spend your time doesn't concern me. What stuff are you into?
I airlift wooden gnomes out of sockets. With birds.
So where? Why? How?
Black market trinket rings. Big money.
Couldn't you just use the mail?
Okay, sure, yeah. Okay, so as we can see here, this Steve guy has trained birds to carry parcels of wooden gnomes for some reason. Sure, why not? Okay, so... as you can see here, the bluebirds... freight must be balanced evenly between the bird's two legs. So, the bluebirds... that's shown here carrying... one bag of two... gnomes... must be able to carry one per leg. It is also shown, and they're also shown here carrying one bag with a mallard, and shared with a mallard, which can carry, presumably, two per leg. Matt going with the bluebirds, one per leg, and the fact there are three gnomes in the bag. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's 10, which means that 2 mellor at legs, 4, so 14 in total. Okay, let's do this one again. Okay, Mallard can carry two Unomas per leg, so I was right about that. And now 1.5, a bluebird 1. Birds may team up on heavy loads, each carrying what he can. Freight must be balanced evenly between a bird's two legs. So like a bluebird... no, Mallard couldn't, and carry both a 2 and a 1, and for example, lines can't, rule 4 is lines can't cross or the shipment will become tangled. Alright, let's work this out. Okay, so obviously one leg of this mallard goes to this one, and one leg goes to this one. That leaves three gnomes left in here to carry, so one goes to that from that leg, one from this leg, and one from this leg, total of... total of 5. So 2 from this rope, and 3 from these 3 ropes. And then 1 from this rope, and from this bluebird's leg to this bag. Finally, both ropes from this owl to this bag, like leaving us with 2. One rope from this mallard to here, leaving us with none in this bag. To account for the weight of, and one from this leg to this bag. Thank you.
again, Steve.
Aw, no new puzzles from him.
Hello, gentlemen. A bit early for a lunch break, isn't it?
Until the eraser factory opens again, Daryl and I have nowhere else to go.
Yeah, me and Daryl got nowhere else to go.
Oh, that's great. Then you don't mind if I ask you a few questions?
Yeah, yeah. As soon as I get these bugs back in place.
What? Why do you have bugs in a diner?
You gonna help or not?
Okay, yeah, sure. Alright. So, the rules for this puzzle. So it looks just like that. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1 and 2. 1 and 2. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. 1, 2. And 1, 2, 1, 2. So they both have. Yeah.
Questions?
Sure. Fire them at me.
What do you know about the guy fixing the sign outside?
Randall Sprothman. Weird guy. He thinks the trees talk to him.
Yeah, but he sure picked the right line of work. He's gonna be employed forever. Stuff always needs fixing.
I think he looks extra hard to stop the fix around here.
Yeah, so he can be close to Glory. She's the waitress here. Sweeter than moose milk in the morning.
You guys know what happened to the foreman?
Yeah, the lobster bit him.
Shut up, Daryl.
What do you mean a lobster bit him?
He means Mike Lobb. Mike and Isaac didn't get along all the time. Had a little bit of a fight.
That's because Isaac thought he was smarter than all of us floor guys.
Well, he probably is.
No, he ain't. Just because he's a college boy don't make him smart.
You two are employed at the factory. Would you say it's a safe place to work?
As safe as any other place, I guess.
Yeah, except the new wing is haunted.
No, it isn't. You'd better quit listening to those hippies.
Why do you think the new wing is haunted?
When the factory expanded, we built a new wing. A bunch of locals got angry. We had to clear out part of the forest to do it.
Because spirits live in the forest.
You mentioned something about spirits in the forest. Really?
Depends on who you ask.
You won't see me out in the woods after sundown.
Well, me neither. But there ain't no spirits.
Thanks, gentlemen.
Anytime.
Okay, sure.
Hello, Sheriff.
Agent Kevin, good. You're here.
Yeah, listen, I wanted to ask you...
No time. I got a hunch about the factory. I got security camera records here of people leaving the factory. It'd be helpful to talk if you ever left one.
Okay, well, we can immediately put this one into last because because it's the only one where the car's gone. And following the footprints in the snow, this one must be second. That was easy. A lot easier than it should have been, really. Oh well, yeah, basically exactly what I've just put down, really. This one's first, this one's second, third, and fourth. Okay.
What was the name of the factory worker I'm looking for?
Last guy to leave the factory was Mike Lobb. Drive out to Sesame Woods, then walk the trail out to the ice fishing hut.
Sure.
Is there anything I should know about the Sesame Woods?
They've got the odd wolverine in them.
What?
But they're probably hibernating or migrating or the like.
I better get back.
You betcha.
Snow must be playing tricks on my eyes. For a second, I thought I saw... It doesn't matter. I'm on my way to question Mike Lobb at the ice fishing huts. But to get there, I have to go through Sesame Woods. That doesn't sound dangerous at all.
Next up, Sesame Woods. That's it, I guess.
Found Isaac Dabner's ID badge. Looks like he came this way sometime before the accident. Why was Lobster, Mike Lobb, out here as well?
That's a good question. I'm curious. Ah, no, I didn't mean to do that. Yeah, back.
Ah, that does mean...
Hello? I think I found Mike Lobb. Man, late 30s. Looks like he froze to death, trying to solve some sort of problem. I'm gonna have a look.
Alright, this one is actually really tricky. So, first, you want to make sure that one is turned that way. That one turned that way. That one that way. That one that way. That way. That way. Yeah, that looks good. Oh, thank God.
No puzzle's gonna stop me in my tracks. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean...
They tried to take him. The lock must be not...
The lock on the factory door.
Key...
What is this thing? I think I found something important in the hands of a dead lobster. I'm going to hold on to it for later. The lake with the ice fishing huts is just past the clearing. I'm going to continue on to see if anyone there seems to have this affliction.
Huh.
Found some freshly caught fish out on the lake. Looks like something has started eating them before they've been cooked.
Well, that's gross.
Mr. Scruffman.
You following me, boy?
No, sir. I can't leave until I get that factory back open. I have a few more questions for you.
Of course you do.
this your hut? It's nice.
Nope.
Oh. Well, what are you doing then?
Fixing stuff. It's your job. Lots of stuff getting broke lately.
Things get broken on these huts a lot?
Everything gets broken a lot. Keeps me busy.
Hmm.
Don't get any ideas. I just do my job.
I understand you have a thing for Mrs. Dabner.
What's that? I just think she's pretty. I expect you do as well.
Where were you on the night of the accident?
Busy.
Usually it's something. I'm just asking. It's part of my job to be thorough.
I was looking at the whole time.
Okay, see? That was easy.
Back to the end then. Oh, I didn't see that last time we were here.
That shop recently hired the local high school football team.
The whole team?
Yeah.
Huh. Wow, this is new. Okay, sure. Yeah, that looks right.
Well, that takes care of that one. Again, Mr. Bjorn?
Yeah.
Do you know Randall Struffman?
I do. He's a good man. Good stock.
Despite his stock, you think he could have had anything to do with the accident at the factory?
Why don't you just let things run their course? Accidents happen, Mr. Tethers.
So, Randall Struffman.
He's a valuable member of this community, and that'll be enough of you trying to say otherwise.
You think Glory Dabner's capable of violence? So that's a no. What was that? Heard a crash and a scream coming from inside the inn. Going inside to see what happened. I hope I won't need backup. I heard a scream. Is everything okay in here?
The pipe on the fireplace! Turn my back on it for 1 second and boom!
Okay, don't panic. I'm sure we can find a way to fix it.
Oh, jeez. Okay. Well.
Stole some pipe. Going after it. Checking out.
Oh my, but what about my furnace? You're all done?
Yes, ma'am. I'll be calling in the FBI's gnome squad. Or the National Guard, or the... someone better equipped to handle your situation.
Oh, I see. Guess I'll be needing to call the sheriff then and let him know.
Excuse me?
Yeah, the sheriff told me to give him a buzz the moment you left town.
Why would the sheriff assume I was leaving so soon?
Oh, I couldn't say. So, will that be on a credit card, or should I just send the bill to Uncle Sam?
What is Sherrif Bahg hiding? And that lock, it's on the outside of the door. On second thought, I better stick around. See this through.
Oh, great. Hot dish all around.
I think the sheriff wants me out of town. And what is the deal with that gear I found on Mike Law? I need to see a man about a furnace pipe. What was that thing? What happened? Did it try to eat your ear?
If two rows are right, rotations affect orientation, and then...
Huh?
Okay, yeah. This is just weird, but... So, basically... You have to place 5 arrows along the path in these blank squares. That was fucking terrifying, actually. We're going to place the right arrow there, a left here, right here, left here, and another left up here. Also, that background is fucking terrifying. Didn't seem carrying the pipe.
I got your pipe back. Let's finish putting this back together.
Yeah, he definitely, it's definitely a very surreal game, to be honest, and honestly. I'm really not sure how else to describe it. Other than exactly that, it's a very, very surreal game. Yeah, that looks right.
Your stove's all fixed.
Why, thank you, Mr. Tethers. You FBI types sure are handy.
Thank you. Can I ask you something?
Of course.
You seem relatively coherent. Do people ever talk about seeing, little people in pointy hats?
Oh, the hidden people. Yeah, it's an old Nordic superstition. My grandfather used to tell me stories. They say they live among us in the ground, trees, rocks. I just know the ones that live in my window.
Right, so when we come back next episode, we will talk to her about the other two questions we need to ask her, and then we'll head off to figure out the next part of our investigation. So, if you've enjoyed the video, a like rating is very much appreciated. Hit the subscribe button down below to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have subscribed already but you haven't been in receiving notifications, then please click the bell icon down below right next to the subscribe button to make sure that you don't miss any notifications for videos in the future. Share the video with your friends if you think they might enjoy my content. Leave a comment down below if you have any thoughts. And my Facebook, Twitter, and Discord information is, as usual, in the description box down below. Alright, with that done,
I'll see you guys next time for more Nelson Tethers Puzzle Agent. Until then, Josh, out.